I really wanted to implement a proper fly hack for Pwn Adventure 3. After fiddling around when doing this on Linux, I thought I could need some help when doing this on Windows. So I contacted Guided Hacking, who makes awesome, easy to follow game hacking videos, and asked for some help. I asked him if he can figure out how to make a fly hack and then explain it to me, and then we have a YouTube collab. He said yes and followed up with a basic plan. The best way to do a fly hack is to overwrite your current position values, like you do, but you get the next position variable for flying forward using trigonometry. You do what's called a translation, moving a 3D coordinate in a specific direction. You can do this with matrix multiplication using the worldview projection matrix, but it's easier to just do simple trigonometry, cosine, sine, arctan, etc. I already have code written for this that I can share. I actually wrote this code because Steven Chapman asked a question on Stack Overflow and I knew the answer, so I felt like a boss. Steven Chapman is another awesome YouTuber with some game hacking videos, so that's why that's funny. So here's the code. You can see here a function move in camera direction, and then it does some trigonometry. If you are still in school, you should really pay attention to trigonometry and especially matrix stuff. If you are interested in game hacking or game development, you need that foundation. Anyway, a few hours later, Guided Hacking got back to me with a Visual Studio project and some code. But he added that something is not right. Here it is in its broken state if you want to take a look. Of course I want to take a look. So what is it that Guided Hacking sent me? In the folder you can find a SLN file, so that's a solution file, a project file for Visual Studio. Let's open it up and have a look. Let's start with the DLL main CPP. This defines the entry point for the DLL application. Based on this here, how to hack any game, first internal hack DLL tutorial. And here's a good description of what this is all about. Internal hacks are created by injecting a dynamic link library or DLL into the game process. When you do this, you have direct access to the process's memory, which means fast performance and simplicity. Normally, a DLL is used to export functions and to be used like a lib, accessing the functions from the lib when necessary. But in our case, we are just going to use them to get our code to run in a target process. Injected DLLs can be made more sneaky by using different injection methods, such as manual mapping. So yeah, this Visual Studio project is just creating a DLL. And when the DLL is injected into the target's process, the DLL main entry point will be executed. The system calls the entry point function for a DLL when it's loaded or unloaded using the load library and free library function. And upon the DLL process attach case, we create a new thread so that it can run in parallel in the background. The hack thread. And this hack thread then does the magic. Remember, you have to imagine that this code is now running in the Pwn Adventure game process. And so here you can see that it uses getModuleHandle to get the handle to the GameLogic DLL module, which basically returns the address where it is loaded. And you can see it being used here in the function findDMA, direct memory access, address. And here we have the start address, followed by a pointer path list. Pointer path, they are just everywhere. We can also peek into the findDMAAddict function to see how it works. It's very simple. PTR is the starting address and is assigned to the variable address. Offset is a vector or a list of the offsets. And here we have a loop that loops over those offsets. So address and this address, we have a value that is another address. So we dereference that now, which means we follow that address. So address is now the new address and we add the offset to that address. This should now point to a new location that stores another pointer or address. So in the next loop, we dereference that and follow that address. So now address is that new address. We add the offset and we get the new location. And we do that for all offsets and then return the final address. If we can cast the pointer we found to, for example, a 3D vector, then we have now a position variable pointing into that memory. That's how we can then read or write those values. So apparently Guided Hacking found some position and angle vectors at these locations in memory. Around this code, you can also see get async key state, which checks if you pressed a certain key. Here, the numpad key. This is used to enable or disable the fly hack. And also numpad 5 is apparently used to move into camera direction, so this should fly around. And with the end key, it should break. Then of course return, this should exit the thread. By the way, there's also a call to alloc console, which is another Windows API function that will create a new console for the calling process. And then with std cout, you can write text out to the console. I actually didn't know that it's that simple to create a console for a process. Cool. Alright, now, guided tagging already said that it doesn't work. But this is already very helpful because we can build upon that. We can use it as a template. In the last video, I showed you how I found the camera position and view direction. This means we could now use those pointer paths. So let's create a new DLL project. Visual Studio++, Windows Desktop, Dynamic Link Library DLL, and we call it Pwn3Hux. If we look into the source files, we can see that Visual Studio already created the DLL main.cpp file with the DLL main entry point function. As you can see, looks pretty similar to the example code by guided tagging. So let's just copy and paste that code. Visual Studio already warns us about types like file that can't be found. For that, we need to include IOs. Looks already better, but of course the mem namespace and this vector 3 is also still unknown. Let's add the include of the mem header, and then we have to add a new file, header mem.h. Copy and paste that code. And then we also need the mem.cpp file. Copy that too. Wow, we are incredible fast programmers, copy and paste, but don't tell anybody the secret of programming. Shh, let them all think you need to remember everything. So the mem.cpp by guided tagging defines three functions, patch, nop, and finddmaddy. The last function we already looked at. Patch and nop are very similar. They both use the virtual protect Windows API function to change the permission of this memory area to be writable. You have to do this in case it's non-writable memory like the assembly code. But after that, you can simply use memcopy or memset to that address and override it. Patch will of course copy the bytes you want to patch, and memset writes assembly nop instruction, which is a hex 90. And let's also add the geometry files geom.h, which gives us the 3D vector vec3 and the geom.cpp file, which contains some trigonometry functions. After we included the mem.h in the DLL main, we can also try to compile it. Ctrl-Shift-B, and we built it. We have pwnhux.dll. Let me quickly modify a bit the code, because my keyboard doesn't have a numpad. The key that should toggle the fly hack enable or disable, I set to left control key. And the flying around I set to the right mouse key. We know this doesn't work yet, so let's remove some of the code here, only keep the position, and then add a debug output with cout to print the position. Let's try it out. Compile the DLL. There we go. Now we just need to figure out how to inject the DLL. Because I don't want to go into detail right now how DLL injection works, we are just using a tool. Actually, Cheat Engine can also inject the DLL. It's here in the Tools menu. But I'm going to use Guided Tagging's injector tool. It has a lot of features, I guess at least. I have no clue. I'm just gonna try to load a DLL. So here we specify the process we want to inject to, and here we select the DLL file. The build DLL is in the debug folder, pwn3hux.dll. After that, we can hit inject. And that seems to have worked because we get the console with the debug output. Now we are in game. If we press the left control key, we should be able to toggle between the fly hack on and off. That works. Now that it's on, let's try to press the right mouse key and see what happens. Oh, game crashed. I guess this doesn't work at all. So let's quickly take the pointer path we have identified with Cheat Engine and replace it here. By the way, pay attention to the correct pointer, because we cast this memory to a 3D vector, we need the pointer to the first X coordinate. And it turned out I labeled them wrong, and when I tested it, I read garbage values. So the first coordinate is at offset hex 90. So let's build it again and inject it into the game. Enable flyhack, press right mouse button, and we see output. We can now move around and observe the player's position, or more precisely the camera's position. If we jump, we also see the Z value change. Awesome, we can build upon that. Thanks, guided tagging, for making this so easy for me.